1970s, where a small Colorado race called the Red Zinger begins to attract a following. Greg LeMond, an early hero, the blonde-haired, blue-eyed sensation, taking on the Soviets in the 1981 Coors. LeMond and Connie Carpenter, triumphant victors on the final day. The 1980s found LeMond under the tutelage of Bernard Hinault, the French superstar. But LeMond found disappointment, ordered by his bosses to sacrifice his own ambition in the 1985 Tour de France, while a struggling Hinault maintained pace. The American believed he'd been aced out. That same year, LeMond and Hinault brought their intra-squad feud to America. But here, Hinault watched as LeMond claimed another Coors victory. 1986 now, and Hinault fights again, but the American will not be denied. The Tour de France win confirms his greatness.
The year is 1986, and Greg LeMond stands atop the cycling world. The trophies, fame, and fortune visible proof of his talent and determination. He was a young man who had it all. A simple diversion, hunting with his brother-in-law, brought it all crashing down. Fast forward to 1989, and America's most famous cyclist is riding again, recovered from the accident and a series of nagging injuries that nearly ended his career.
Incredibly challenging and incredibly difficult, and it's one of the few sports that aren't really, you're not allowed to have injuries, because if you do have an injury, it takes a long time to come back because it's so competitive. We're highly trained athletes that take a lot of training, and if you have an accident like I did, you don't come back in 1 year. It's a three-year process.
While Greg has been away, America's other top pros have enjoyed their own success. Greg LeMond makes his re-entry into cycling as the leader of an all-new team.
I think our team, is the Coors Light team, as a whole team for the United States, is as strong as probably any team going right now. Especially if I'm riding with it, I think we're stronger than 7-Eleven. I'd like to think that.
With success and good business sense, Greg has given his growing family a secure future, splitting his time between homes in Belgium and Minneapolis.
I'd like to be able to spend more time in the United States, and especially as you get older, you think I've been living in Europe for 8 years now, and this is my ninth year. You'd think that I'd be getting less homesick and enjoy it more in Europe, and I think as I get older, the more I want to come back to the United States. I think that's going to be a major factor in my cycling is how long I'm willing to stay in Europe.
The Tour de Trump ushers in a new era for American cycling. An American, Greg LeMond, believes his own time at the top can return.
I think that even if I'm not as good as I was when I won the Tour de France, I'm capable of winning major races.
Next up, Greg LeMond, America's 1986 hero, attempting to regain lost glory. Having a place to get away from cycling and be with his family has always been important to Greg LeMond. Greg is the proverbial family man, enjoying an afternoon with his wife Kathy and sons Jeffrey and Scott, more than a morning victory on the bike. And he cherishes every moment, knowing that he might not be here at all. He remembers the day 2 years ago when he almost lost his life.
I went to stand up to see who had shot, and I just realized I'd been shot, and I couldn't breathe. My right lung collapsed at the time.
Hunting turkey, LeMond was accidentally shot by his brother-in-law. 60 pellets were removed from his body. 30 remain in him, including two that are lodged in the lining of his heart.
Started, you know, thinking maybe I'll die. Everything went through my mind. Main thing was I wanted to see Kathy and my kids.
Less than a month later, a celebration of life. Greg was back in the hospital, but this time to see the birth of his son, Scott. Scott is now two, and there have been few bright spots athletically for Greg LeMond in those 2 years after battling back from the hunting accident. He was felled by appendicitis, and then a serious case of tendonitis took Greg off the bike another season, so he was unable to train or even ride in races he might otherwise have won. Of course, Le Mans is hardly a tragic figure. His stunning career began with a bang at the tender age of 22, when he won the World Championship of Cycling in 1983 in Switzerland. This victory proved to the cycling world that Le Mans was a potential star and helped destroy the myth that an American could not succeed against European racers. A brash, confident Le Mans announced at the time that his next ambition was to win the prestigious Tour de France. From the beginning, Le Mans was taken under the wing of one of the greatest racers of all time, Frenchman Bernard Hinault. Hinault was the American's partner, mentor, coach, and father figure. It was at times, though, an intensely competitive partnership. In 1985, Le Mans helped Hinault win a record fifth Tour de France. But in the 1986 Tour, when the Frenchman had promised to repay Greg for his sacrifice and help Le Mans win his first Tour, Hinault changed his mind, and Greg found himself alone in a battle against the great Frenchman in a French race against the entire French nation. Despite the odds, he became the first American to win the race, but because of what Hinault had put him through, he couldn't enjoy his victory.
You know, if there was a point in my career to have an accident, it was at that time. It gave me time to get remotivated. I'm very motivated, and more dedicated than I've ever been in my whole career.
But the fact is, it's been almost 3 years since he won the Tour de France, and Greg Le Mans has not won a race since. Experts say he's perhaps in the best shape of his career, but he'll have to race to prove it.
I don't know what to expect for the Trump race. I don't know what to expect after 8 days or 9 days of racing. I could perform great. I might have one day I'm cooked, but I doubt it. I'm sure I'm going to have a pretty good race.
Well, Le Mans about to find out in this prologue time trial, the event they call the Race of Truth. Before the accident, Le Mans was a feared time trialist, a man whose talents and courage defied all odds. But now, on the treacherous surface of the Empire Plaza, Le Mans demonstrates a kind of caution only a man who's come face to face with death will ever know. But then again, even at his peak, Le Mans was never one to savor racing in the rain. Perhaps was he playing the wily veteran, knowing that seconds lost here mattered less than minutes gained later. Shrouded in the eerie glow of an Albany twilight, Le Mans seemingly still bedeviled. In the end, the one-time Tour de France champion would finish 65th. And so a racing star once nearly invincible on American soil was forced to accept an early modest role.
Was among them Dag Otto Lauritzen enjoying the spotlight generated by his pink race leader's jersey and strong 7-Eleven supporting cast. Greg Le Mans says he's beginning to feel better, but continues to face questions about his team.
I think it's not as easy as people think just to throw together a team and race as well as a team that's been together for 7 years, 6 years. And I think we're doing extremely well. I think in other races we've challenged 7-Eleven, and Tour of Americas we beat them. Tour of Texas we would have beat them, but it came down to just one last race. We were leading. And this race, it's been somewhat of a disaster for the team itself, the riders and myself. Everything's been going wrong, and but it's not the first time it's happened in my career. It's been I've seen that happen many times in other teams, and 7-Eleven's had those experiences too. And their day is right now, but who knows what's going to happen in the Tour de France or other races.